Soweto was built to keep black workers out of Johannesburg. You got to live in Soweto as long as you had a job. If you lost your job, you were supposed to lose your home. They wanted to control us and make us migrant commuters with no roots. But we took root.
My name is Zulu Bidi. I was born on the 13th of March, 1945. That was in Shantytown, just the west side of Orlando East. My mother had gone to fetch some water and it was just about to rain. You know, the clouds were closing up and it was getting darker, windy. There came Zulu. And my father just decided to call me Zulu Liaduma. Zulu Liaduma meaning thunderstorm. My father died in 1956. I was 11 years old then, I think. When he died, life was pretty hard for our mother. I didn't finish school, by the way. I'd go out and sell some things, you know, like oranges, peanuts, sweets, so as I could afford to pay school fees for my two younger sisters, who were lucky enough to actually go to school. I couldn't.
People are still scared to go out after dark. There's so much crime around. The jazz clubs, the cinemas have all closed now. There's nowhere to go. There's nothing left but your own front room and TV. ZB met Portia here at the Pelican Club.
Lucky came about with this idea of opening a jazz club in Soweto, which was the very first.
And this is the club I'm talking about. Club Pelican. This was the only one. And everybody flew up to here.
Sometimes I wouldn't get a seat myself.
We closed down, it was 86, 87, somewhere. And there was too much unrest in the area, and it was just too dangerous to continue operating.
I thought probably I should start doing something after the jazz scene was dying and we were kicked out of the clubs in town and things like that. There was a period, a horrible period actually, when we were not wanted at all, you know, and we didn't have unions and things, and so I just had to do something. This is Ostrich. As you can see, it's made by me, Zulu Bidi Exclusives. Zulu Bidi Exclusives, Soweto, that's all. After putting the pieces together, which is how I learned, I taught myself how to make a shoe. And so I don't know the exact techniques as to how other people go about it. But then, this is the beginning. This is one piece, second piece, third piece here, and the backing.
I found myself to be one of the people who never had a chance to be educated, but then I just pushed my way through. I just hustled, and I just told myself, shit, I'm gonna do this. Some take a different direction, probably become a criminal and maybe make things better for his life. And this is how a black man survived all the years.
I used to sing with a close harmony group, just voices and a little bit, maybe guitar, bass and drums. And so I got interested into playing an instrument. I tried, my first instrument I tried was to buy a piano, which I fetched from Zimhlophe on a horse cart.
She sounds beautiful. You can hear. just ringing, bus sounds. A woman, look at the shape. There is the head, the neck, the figure, and the figure. And of course, you know, I had somebody say, my first wife. Yes, she is my first chick in life. I fell in love with her when I was very young. So I kept on there. And my wife Portia comes after her.
No, it's okay with me. I do understand the first wifey.
That's it.
I'm playing fine.
That's it. That's it. Giddy giddy gagata. Giddy giddy gagata. Ah! That smiles.
To play this tune for you called Over the Rainbow. Thank you. That's the tune for the Rainbow Nation. How's that?
This is the crowd. The underground culture of car racing. Everyone is just here. Everyone is here on his own risk. is the culture of drugs then. This is the underground culture of South Africa. This is what happens here. Every evening on Thursday. All this is illegal. Last time cops were here shooting and tear gassing everyone. Then this is the culture of drugs.
Hunting game is a